Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Brother Patrick. I already made two good videos. I know the last one was really awesome. You know, I'd like to load all my videos in one day, but I think that it's like on the feed thing. It's kind of confusing. I'd hate to get a good video buried by another video, and then people get to see it. So I try to usually put out like one a day, maybe one in the morning, one at night, so people have a chance to see it if it's good. Of course, if I've made a video that's just not a big deal, not so great, I will just go ahead and load another one. Anyway, I got the list. It's like 50 names on here. I'm going to try my best, at least start on it. If I can't get finished, then I'll do a partial video. So, let's get started. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, I thank you for your Holy Spirit. I thank you for, Lord, that all things comes by your hand. Father, we thank you in Jesus' name right now, Lord God. I want to pray. Let's start with Stephanie F. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, Lord, I just seek a word. For Stephanie F., Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Lord God, I give you the praise and the glory, Lord God. We seek your face, Lord God, for your wisdom, for brothers and sisters in Christ, Lord God, and flow by your spirit, not by might or by power, but by your spirit, Lord God. You know, Sister Stephanie, sometimes the Lord will give a weird word. I'll tell people to their face, and then, you know, when I'm praying with people, and hey, they understand what it means. But the Lord has just shown me something about, you know, like a fluffy marshmallow. So I don't know what that might mean. That's kind of weird. That's why I've been hesitating on saying it. That's why I kept praying. Marshmallows or marshmallow. I don't know what that means, but maybe it means something to you. And this is what the Lord just keeps saying to me. Right now, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I'm praying for Sister April in Jesus' name. Brothers and sisters who are watching this video, I ask you to come in agreement. There's no time in the Lord, no space, even though you're watching this after I made it. Your prayers are still in agreement with me since the Lord is outside of time. Right now I pray for April in the name of Jesus. Lord God, I just would speak, Lord God, your wisdom upon her. And there's more than one April. There's one April I know who is from Louisiana. And it seems like, I don't know if this is her or not. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, I give you the praise. I give you the praise. I give you the praise. Father, and the Lord is showing me like a motorcycle, you know, like that. Okay, now I got it. The Lord is focusing, just so you guys can learn, the Lord is focusing on the handlebars. And I've never seen it that way before, but what the Lord is meaning, because the Lord will do a play on words. Sometimes the Lord speaks to me directly and clearly, and sometimes he does a play on words. So the first one I got, marshmallow, that is some kind of a play on words or some other meaning. And then the second one, the handlebars. So the Lord is showing me that, like, there's something that April can handle, and the Lord is like saying she can handle it. She can handle the situation, whatever you're praying about. Because there's people, some of the people that, like, they messaged me and they had, like, all these comments. When people asked me for a word, I didn't read your statement, if you made some statement, because I wanted to give you a word not tainted by what you told me. So, April, the Lord is saying the situation, you can handle it. Now, like I said, I'm telling you guys this stuff so you can understand. And usually the Lord shows me lots of times by the same way I normally see or hear. But in this case, he's showing me something in different ways that I've never seen before. Sister Vicky, right now I'm praying, Father, in the name of Jesus for Sister Vicky. Lord God, I give you the praise. I give you the glory, Lord. Now the Lord is just showing me a waterfall, a waterfall. So, of course, a waterfall to me, normally I see a waterfall for myself. I see like Niagara Falls, and it represents the power of the Holy Spirit. Now, this is a smaller waterfall, a real small one. So I would believe that the Lord is saying about the power of God in your life, that the Lord, you know, you have power in your life, but the Lord wants you to have more power of His Holy Spirit in your life. Now, there is some power, and just like I made a video just earlier, and I guess I'll load these tomorrow. It's already like 11 o'clock at night. You know, the song that I played at the end of the last video, more love, more power, more of you in my life. So the Lord wants to give you more of His power, more of His power, more of His Holy Spirit power, that dynamite power of the Holy Spirit in your life. Maybe that's what you've been praying about. You've been praying for more power, more of the Holy Spirit power in your life, and the Lord is saying He's going to give it to you in Jesus' name. Keep seeking, asking, and knocking in Jesus' name. Sister Ellie, Right now, Father, I pray for Sister Ellie in the name of Jesus. I pray for Sister Ellie in the name of Jesus. Father, I give you the praise and the glory. Now, the Lord is telling me something that I want you to pray. I want everybody to pray for Sister Ellie. I don't really want to give some people a bad word. Something bad, you know, there's something coming up in your life that's not good. Something, you know, bad. And the Lord is saying that He's with you, and the Lord wants you to seek Him. We're going to pray for you. I want you to seek the Lord. And like I say, I don't know how many times I've ever given someone a word like this, but by the grace of God, I can only give you what He says. And what I hear is something wicked this way comes. And I want you to be cautious. I want you to be prayerful. I want you to seek the Lord God Almighty, and the Lord is going to see you through it. But the Lord wants you to be prepared. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a sound mind. So, you know, just be, you know, it's not a matter of being fear, but being watchful, being alert that this situation, God gives us authority. God wants you to seek Him. Have your faith in the Lord Jesus Christ. He will make a way for you, Sister Ellie. We have authority. When we are saved, we have authority in the name of Jesus over everything in this world. Even all the power of the enemy. Jesus said we can walk upon scorpions and snakes. We can walk right over the top of them. They're under our feet in the name of Jesus. But you need to be prepared. Be prepared. Be at peace. Be at rest in the Lord. Read Psalm 91. Read the 23rd Psalm. The Lord is with you. The Lord is with you. Be prepared. But Father, right now we pray for Sister Ellie in the name of Jesus, Lord. Strengthen her, Lord God. Father, give her wisdom, Lord. Show me if there's anything else I need to tell her, Lord. Lord, I've given her that warning from you. Something wicked this way come. You know, I mean, I don't know. I'm just going to say, guess, Sister Ellie. I don't know. The Lord didn't tell me. Maybe there's something in your life or someone in your family's life that's inviting this in. You know, you need to deal with that. Like I said, if you sent me a message, I didn't read it. You need to, you know, evangelize your relatives or some sin in your life. I don't know that. See, people want a word. I got to give you a word. There's something that needs to be dealt with. You need to deal with it, Sister Ellie. Either yourself or your husband or your children or whatever. Relatives, you got to deal with this wicked. Or maybe you have a relative that's going to come visit you and they're trying to bring, you know, they're trying to bring some evil in your home. I don't know exactly. But I've got to give this word, and you know I'm accountable to the Lord. This is a serious thing, and it's not about being afraid. There's lots of people. There's a sister, every time she hears something, she's looking for something negative, looking for something fearful. She's full of fear. I've talked to her many times and said, you know, sister, God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power and love and a sound mind. Every little thing, she's just in fear. Everything she hears on YouTube, don't be like that. God has not given us a spirit of fear, but a power and of love and a sound mind. 2 Timothy 1:8. Sam, Brother Sam. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, I pray for Brother Sam. Hallelujah, Father, we give you the praise. Hallelujah, Lord. We give you the praise, Lord God, as we pray for Brother Sam. And the Lord is saying that you're eligible. You're eligible. I don't know if you're applying for something or what. The Lord has given me these words all over the place that's not that I normally give. You know, as the Lord had made me make these, you know, led me to make these videos, and I know the Lord is expanding and increasing my gifting instead of just straight Bible verses, you know, more specific stuff. The Lord says you're eligible. You're eligible. You're eligible for whatever it is maybe you're praying about or seeking a job or whatever it is or something from the Lord. You're eligible in Jesus' name. Father, right now in the name of Jesus, I pray for Sister Ginger. Now, I do remember Sister Ginger. I've talked to her a little bit, and I believe it's her father has cancer, and she was asking me to pray about it, if I'm not mistaken. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, Lord, we speak for the Father. I can't remember if she said he was saved or not. We pray for him to be healed. We pray for his salvation above all things, because Jesus said, in Jesus' name, Jesus said, you know, if your right eye offends you, pluck it out. It's better to enter heaven with one eye than enter hell with seeing. You know, so we pray, number one, for his salvation. That's number one, that he's right with God, that he's going to heaven. Secondly, if he is a Christian, then we pray for him to be healed of his cancer, or that he be healed of his cancer, though he will get saved. Father, make a way in Jesus' name. I pray for Sister Ginger to have peace. I speak peace right now like a river in Jesus' name for Sister Ginger. Now, Sister Kathy, Deer Valley. Father, right now, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, I give you the praise and the glory right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah, Father, we praise you, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord is just telling me to tell you that, you know, when the enemy comes in like a flood, he will lift up a standard against him. The Lord said, even though the enemy is camped around about you, hallelujah, there's a Bible verse that says the enemy stands against me. He rises up all around. I believe it's the third psalm. It's for you. Arise, O Lord. You know, arise, O Lord, and help me. It's the third psalm. I want you to read that, Sister Kathy from Deer Valley. Liz, Sister Liz, Father, in the name of Jesus, I speak right now. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, Father, we praise you, Lord God. And the Lord's saying, maybe he's talking to me, that's why I'm hesitating, you know, for me to handle you with kid gloves or you to handle some situation with kid gloves. So in other words, be gentle, be careful, be cautious, be slow, be graceful in a situation that you're trying to handle. Handle it with kid gloves. That's what the Lord is telling me, you know, with a velvet glove. Handle it gently, and God will be the one to make a way. In Jesus' name. Brother Rocky, right now, Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for Brother Rocky. Lord God, I pray for his victory right now, Lord God. I pray for him to have the victory over death, hell, and the grave. In Jesus' name. Right now, I decree and declare that Rocky has victory over death, hell, and the grave in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. No weapon formed against Brother Rocky shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against thee, thou shalt condemn. This is the inheritance of the saints of God, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. Isaiah 54:17. Brother Rocky, that's for you from the Lord. Hallelujah. Sister Lucy, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, we pray for Sister Lucy. Hallelujah, Lord God. Father, we praise you. We praise you, Father, in Jesus' name. And the Lord is just showing me a fish. Hallelujah. The Lord is just showing me a fish that being pulled out of the water. So I believe it's, you know, that someone that you're praying to get saved will get saved. Or you will lead someone to the Lord. You will fish someone. You will lead someone to the Lord. Or maybe it's your relatives you're praying for, your husband or whatever. It's going to get saved. Or you, the Lord will use you to bring someone to the Lord. The Lord is showing me a fish coming out of the water. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise and the glory in Jesus' name. Sister Shelby. Shelby, hallelujah. Father, we give you the praises. I pray for Sister Shelby right now. Hallelujah, Lord God. We praise you, Lord God. Praise you, Father, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord has just shown me a robe. It looks kind of like a graduation robe. The Lord has shown me a robe that someone wore, like a judge's robe or a graduation robe. I can't see what color it is. Sometimes I can. It seems to be almost like it's purple. Father, so not maybe necessarily a robe of righteousness, but like a graduation robe. God bless you in Jesus' name, choir robe or something. God bless you in Jesus' name. Maybe you're praying about being in the choir, or maybe you know that about a graduation. That's I can only tell you what the Lord would show me. God bless you, Shelby, in Jesus' name. Brother Roy, Uncle Sam, God bless you in Jesus' name. Father, I give you the praise and the glory right now, and I speak your strength. I'm Brother Roy in Jesus' name, Lord God. And the Lord is just showing me about Oregon, and just speaking to me, Oregon. Maybe, Brother Roy, you're thinking about moving or something. I don't know. But Oregon is the place for you. Oregon is the place to be. Maybe it's the place for your parents or your mother or father. Oregon is the place to be. And God says he set you upon a rock, and he's established you. He's established you in Oregon for the things that you need to do is in Oregon. God bless Brother Roy in Jesus' name. Sister Texine, some of you people who I talk with on YouTube, brothers and sisters, you know, if I had time, I would send you a private message. But I'm making this as the Lord led me because I want it to be a learning. The Lord wants it to be a learning thing for people. And people can learn to exercise the gifts that God would give them and not be afraid or shy to do it. You know, it's just a matter of stepping out by faith, stepping on the water. Sister Texine, stepping by faith, walking on the water like Peter, as the Lord has established you. The Lord has established you in his kingdom. And that's the word from the Lord for you. You are established in the kingdom. Just like Peter, you're a rock, a walking on water rock for the Lord Jesus Christ. And you are established in his kingdom. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, right, but spiritual, to the pulling down of strongholds. And the Lord is just reminding me, now Sister Texine had just asked me a question, a spiritual question, and the Lord said that our weapons are not carnal, but spiritual, to the pulling down of strongholds. And that is connected to the thing that you asked me about this voodoo priest. And, you know, remember that our battle is not against flesh and blood, but against powers and principalities and forces of darkness. So you need to battle this in the spiritual realm. The Lord doesn't want you to battle this in the natural realm. You know what I'm talking about, not getting involved in some kind of legal thing or whatever, or trying to talk to people directly and not get in the flesh because we're talking about family and stuff. But the Lord says that our weapons are not carnal, but spiritual, to the pulling down of strongholds. So go for the spirit realm and handle this in the spirit realm, and the Lord will give the battle into your hand. The Lord gives the battle into your hand right now. In Jesus' name I speak that the battle is in your hand, that the Lord has given this situation into your hand, and you will receive the victory right now in Jesus' name, that the victory is in your hand. The Lord is giving the battle into your hand in Jesus' name. You know, the Lord is just correcting me. I said victory. The Lord is giving the battle into your hand. So in other words, I'm going to private message you, Sister Texine, because it's an important situation. The Lord wants to use you to win this battle, because you had asked me about it. The Lord will use you to win this battle in Jesus' name. And that's really your question. Lisa Maria. This is just the first column, about one-third of the people. Right now, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, I pray for Sister Lisa Maria. Father, I give you the praise for her. I thank you for her, Lord God, that you knew her from the foundation of the world, that you created her in righteousness and holiness to bring glory to your name, that she is a vessel that you can count on. Lord, that in times of suffering, she is a vessel full of strength. Let the weak say, I am strong. Let the poor say, I am rich, for what the Lord has done for us. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Say of the Lord, he is my strength. The Lord is your strength. He's your shield and your buckler. He is your everlasting Father. In the day of battle, the Lord is your victory. Through the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we give you the praise and the glory. Let me just mark this off. I probably need to make more videos. Let me mark this off. That's about 15 people or so. And I will load this one and then make another one. The other people, don't worry. All the other people, I'm still working on it. God bless you guys. I love you guys. You know it, that I'm only a man, but the love of Christ working in my human brain to bring glory to his name. God bless you guys and love you guys. I'll be speaking to you from Dallas. God bless.